Well, guys, welcome back again to my YouTube channel. My name is Christine, and on today's tutorial, we are going to look at how to calculate timber formwork for column. So sometimes you want to cast a column using timber. Formwork can be made of any material. It can be steel, timber, plywood, but this one we are going to use timber. So we want to find the quantities that we are going to use for our timbering. So the components of the timber, we have the sheeting, we have the cleats, we have the struts or the props, we have the yokes and the stoppers. So we are going to find the quantities of each member so that if you want to erect your column, you can know the quantity that you need. Now let's look at the details of the timber formwork that we have. As you can see, we have the vertical formwork, we have the columns, we have the props, we have the wooden planks that are supporting the column. And then on our plan, you can see the yokes, how the yokes are running. And then we have the shutters or the plywood, that is the material that is used to form the column sides. We have the wedges that are used to hold the yokes in place. So guys, let's proceed and calculate the quantities of those components that we need. Now, the column that we are going to calculate the quantities is of size 0.45 meters length and 0.35 meters width with a height of 3.0 meters. As you can look from the drawing, we have the yoke, we have the batten, we have the sheeting. This drawing is showing us how the elements are structured so that they can form the formwork. Now let's proceed to calculating the quantities. The first thing that we are going to calculate is the sheeting material. Sheeting is the material that is used to form the sides of the column. And as you can see here, these are the sides of the column that we have. The first thing that we are going to do is we are going to calculate the peripheral of the column. So that we can be able to calculate the area. The area is the peripheral of the column, then the height of the column. The size of the column is 0.45 meters by 0.35 meter and a height of 3 meters. So the peripheral will be 2 into 0.45 plus 0.35, that gives us 1.6 meters. Therefore, area of the sheeting material will be the peripheral, that is 1.6 times the multiplied by the height, that is 3, giving us 4.8 meter square. Now, since timber is mostly priced in meter cubic, let's calculate the volume. The volume will be the area times the thickness of the sheeting material. That is 4.82 times the thickness of this sheeting material is 25 millimeters, that is 0.025, giving us 0.12 meter cubic. So our step two is to calculate the batten on the cleats. The cleats are used to join the sheeting. It runs vertically and horizontal, depending on the design of the formwork that you want. The cleat timber size for this formwork is 50 by 25 millimeter cleat spaced at 500 center to center. Now let's start with the horizontal cleats. These are the horizontal cleats. You can see they are running on both sides of the length and the width of the formwork. Now let's start by calculating the number. How many are they? The number is calculated by the height divided by the spacing. The height of the column is 3.0 divided by the spacing, which is 0.5 plus 1, we find 7. So we have these cleats here. They are 7 in number in both sides. Now let's find the length. The length will be 2 into this one, 0.45 plus 0.35, that is that one. And then we multiply by 7 because they are 7 in number. That will give us 11.2 meters. The volume will be 11.2 meters by 0.05, that is the size, by the width, which was 0.025. That gives us 0.14 meter cubic of the cleats that we need for this particular formwork. Let's go to the vertical cleats. The number of the vertical cleats can be also be different depending on the formwork design. So in this case, we are going to have two cleats on the shorter side and three on the longer side. You can see we have three, these ones run, the running vertically. We have three of them, and then on the other side we have two of them. Now let's find the total number of cleats for that particular column. Will be 3 plus 2 plus 3 plus 2, because we have 3, 1, 2, 3 plus 2, 1, 2, and then it also applies on the other two sides. So that gives us 10 number. The length of one vertical cleat is 10 meters times the number, which are 10, that gives us 10 meters. So let's calculate the volume. The size of the timber for the vertical and the horizontal cleats are the same, so we still apply the 50 millimeters by 25 millimeter timber size. So our volume will be 10 by 0.05 by 0.025. That gives us 0.0125 meter cubic. So our step three, we are going to calculate the yoke. First of all, let's calculate the number of yokes that are required. If you can look at the drawing here, these are the yokes that we have. These ones here are our yokes. So the yokes are on the longer side of the column on both sides, but on the shorter side of the column, we do not have the yokes. But the design, as I've said earlier, the design is still different depending on the specific design that you have. So for this case, we are using this design whereby we don't have yokes on this side. Now the timber size for the yoke is 50 by 50 millimeters, and they are spaced at 750 millimeters center to center. Now let's find the number. The number is the height divided by the spacing plus 1, that is 3000 millimeters divided by 750 millimeters plus 1, that gives us 5 yokes. Now we have 5 yokes, this side we have 5 yokes, and the other side we have 5 yokes, so the total number of yokes are 10. Now let's find the length of the yoke, of one yoke. One yoke we have from the column, from this point up to this point is 450 millimeters, that is 0.45, but as you can see, we have a projection this side and also a projection this side, that is, we assume 150 millimeters, that is 0.15. So the length of the yoke will be 0.15 plus 450 plus 0.15. So that is the same as 0.45 plus 2 into 0.15, that gives us 0.75. And then we have 10 yokes, so we multiply by 10 to get the total length, that is 7.5 meters. Now let's find the volume, that is the length 7.5 times the timber size 0.05, and then the width is 0.05. That gives us 0.0001875 meter cubic volume of the yokes. Let's calculate the quantity of the clamps. The quantities, the correct quantity required for this formwork is the same as the number of yokes that we have, because the clamps are holding the yokes. So in this case, we are using the clamps. Now, therefore, the number of the yokes are 10. Therefore, the quantity of the clamps that we need are 10 clamps. Let's proceed to calculating the required number of props. Now, these are our props here. These are our props here. So the height at where the props are placed from the bottom of the column, this height here is 1800. And then the props are at an angle of 45 degrees to the ground here. So let's find the length of the prop. So the prop, we are assuming we have two on each side, that is two on the shorter, on the longer side, two on the shorter side, and also on the other side, the same applies. Now start by getting the length of the prop. So the length will be the hypotenuse. So we have the opposite, and then we have an angle, so we are going to use the sine rule. So sine 45 will be opposite of hypotenuse, so the hypotenuse will be 1800 divided by sine 45, that gives us 45.85 meters. Now the size of the props that we are using for this column is 100 by 50 millimeters. Now the number will be we have two on each side, so it's 2 times 4 sides, that is 8. So the total length will be 8 multiplied by the length of 1, which was 2545.58. That gives us 20,364.68 meters. Now let's calculate the volume. It will be the length 20,364.68 multiplied by 0.01 and then multiplied by 0.05. That gives us 1.0182 meter cubic. Now we proceed to calculating the stoppers. The stoppers are the ones that are holding the props into firm, to ensure that the props are firm. So the timber size for the stopper that you have been given is 100 by 100 by 50. So this is the length, this is the width, and this is the thickness. Now, number of stoppers is also the same as the number of the props. So we had 8 props, so meaning we have 8 stoppers, because each prop must have one stopper. So the volume of the stopper will be the timber size, that is 0.01 by 0.01 by 0.05, and then we multiply by the number, that is 8. Therefore we have 0.000004 meter cubic volume of the props. Now the summary of the material that we are going to need for our formwork, that is shattering, is sheeting material. We need 0.12 meter cubic. Cleats, horizontal ones, we need 0.012 meter cubic. The vertical ones, we need 0.0125 meter cubic. The yokes, we need 0.001875 meter cubic. The clamps, we need 10 of them. The props, we need 1.0182 meter cubic. And then the stopper, we need 0.000004 meter cubic. So guys, that is the quantity for your formwork. On our next video, we are going to look at the cost of erecting this formwork. Thank you guys for your time. Thank you for your support. Until next time, bye bye.